Yo, what's up guys? So in this video, I'm gonna teach you guys how to create a cover using PowerPoint. All right guys, so we're in the back end of PowerPoint. What's up, what's going on? So if you guys haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell, and leave a comment down below and say what's up, man. So we're in the back end right here of PowerPoint. I'm gonna show you guys how to create a 6x9 cover right here. Okay, we're gonna get the exact dimensions down. We'll probably throw like a little design on there for an example. And this is the back end right here. This is when you started. And so what I did was come over here to new and then blank presentation, right? And what you're going to do is you're going to want to delete this stuff. Get this stuff out the heck out the way. There it is. Delete it, right? And then we're going to come up here to the left-hand side. It says design. And then we're going to scroll all the way down right here. Slide size, right? And then custom slide size. Now, okay, well, I'm going to take you to... this right here, this information is very important, guys, because if you get this wrong, you mess up everything, right? So you want to understand this right here, okay? Go back and replay this and watch this over and over and over. And like I said, for this example, we're going to do a 6x9, okay? Very important that you guys understand that. And what I would do, too, is basically whatever size covers that or whatever size books you guys are creating, I would save every single one of these to the your actual drive of your computer, your C drive, your D drive, or whatever drive, save it to your computer so you can have a template of these, and you're not going back and forth and doing this over and 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 over, right? It's all about speeding up the process of making your cover so you can have everything there and you can make the best quality cover. Because you don't want to come back and doing this over and over and over. You want to focus on the cover. You want to have the best cover in your niche, right? And that's very important too, guys. If you guys don't understand that, I'll make a video on that too as well, but very important that you guys understand that having the best cover in your niche is important because that's kind of like the thumbnail, right? That's the thing that's going to drive your traffic to that book. They're going to scroll down like, oh, this is a cute cover. Click buy. You know what I mean? Or look, check out the inside or check out your description or whatever. Okay. And then add it to cart and purchase it. So very important that you guys understand this. You guys want to research your niche, right? When it comes to this, research your niche for the covers because it can be... patterns do really well, pictures. And as I mean, what I mean by pictures, like you can take a picture of your city, you can take a picture of, or take a picture of a dog, okay? Take a picture of your dog and put it on a cover. Basically that's what you can do, right? So it's pretty cool. Like you can get very creative with this type of stuff. And there's a lot that you can do, okay, when it comes to covers. So, but like I said, patterns do really well, pictures, of dogs or pictures of whatever the heck niche you're in, they do really well. So let's get straight into this. So we're going to come over here. We are going to come over here to create a paperback cover. And I'll link all this stuff down below in the description, guys. You guys can go and check out everything down there. Formatting your cover background. Okay. Now, the bleed. All covers have a bleed, right? So we want to pay attention to this right here. Okay. So very important. So all covers. Okay. It doesn't matter what size it is. All covers. Okay. It doesn't matter what size your cover is. They all have a bleed. Okay. Straight up. Okay. Also, so adding a text. Okay. This is very important too when it comes to doing your covers, because when you add a text and you have it too close to the bleed, it's going to, Amazon's going to reject it because it's too close to the side and it might cut it off. So very important that you guys understand that too. That's happened to me a few times where I upload 3 books, right? And they get rejected because the text is so close to the edge. I'm like, dang it. Now I got to wait another 2 days. And then obviously right now with the delays, you're waiting like 5 days. So yeah, that's, it kind of sucks. So make sure you guys are paying attention to that as well. So this right here, it's going to give you the breakdown right here on the back end. It's going to give you all the information. I'll put that down below in the description. And then we'll go over to the next one. So now this is the paperback cover templates. This is pretty cool because this is basically, this is going to help you right here, guys. You want to understand this right here. Because depending on the page cover, I mean the page count, this little bad boy right here, your spine is always going to be different depending on the page count, okay? You don't want to mess that up, okay? It's very important. So if you're creating, in this example, we're going to create a page count for 150, right? So what we're going to do is we'll get straight into it right now. So because trim size, we're going to go to 6x9. Where the heck are you? 6x9. page count 150, right? And this is basically how many pages are in your book, okay? So how many pages are in your book, this is what you're gonna put right here, okay? And then the color paper, paper color, sorry, white, and then download. And click right here. It's gonna pop up a little picture for us. All right, little bad boy right here. All right, so now you can see right here the spine, 0.34. So with 150 pages, spine's gonna be 0.34. Now everyone, so if you get 120 pages, it's gonna be different. Okay, the spine dimensions are gonna be different. So you wanna keep note of that. Write it down, keep note of that. Okay, it's very important that you guys understand that, okay? So, all right, now that we got this, okay, this little bad boy, this is gonna be our cheat sheet right here. Okay, our little cheat sheet. You have some little notes. It has notes right here, and right here. And then what we're gonna do is go back to PowerPoint. Bad boy right here. So now we're gonna pull up our little, all right, so now we're gonna pull up our calculator, right? And basically what we're gonna do is the width. Okay, so the width, right? So from left to right, so the width. So we're gonna do, so this is the front page, this is the back page, right? So what we're gonna do, and this is, of course, this is the spine, okay? And then this is the bleed, and remember we have to add 0.125 for the bleed, okay? Left, right, okay? Very important that you guys understand that, very important. So what we're gonna do first, so we are going to do the width. So 6 plus 6, right? It's 12, and then plus 1.25, right? Plus 1.25. Now, what the heck is the spine, right? Remember what I told you about the spine? Don't forget the spine, very important, 0.34, okay? Plus 0.34. And we're gonna 12.59. So 12.59. And then boom. And then no. What the heck am I doing? Forgot the height, right? So what is the height of this? The height. Okay. So it's 9. So this is going to be a little easier, right? So it's going to be 9 inches, right? That's easy, right? So very easy. So because the width, of course, it's the whole left and right. And then the height is just straight up and down, right? So very easy. 9 plus, remember the bleed, 1.25 plus 0.25. 9.25, right? 9.25, right? Okay, looking good. Holla. Okay. Now we're going to ensure fit. And boom. Now. Okay, now we got our correct size down. Okay. Like I said. Now, like, what do you do now? Like, how can I make sure, like, I'm in the, like, you know, have the correct sizing and I'm adding. So basically what you're going to do now is we're going to add some shapes in here to kind of help us keep us, like, there we go. So, all right, boom, okay, and then we're gonna press Control, right? I'm highlighting this basically, and we're gonna add some, like I said, we're gonna add some color in here so we can see what we're designing when we're putting stuff on there. Control C, Control B, and then boom, right? You feel me? Got it? Okay. And then we can change these colors. So for this is an example, guys. This is an example. You can do whatever you want. You can add a little badge here. You can add another shape in here, and you can do whatever you want. Okay. And you put some little lines in there, do whatever you want right here. Right. But in this example, I'm just going to I just want to show you guys how to do it, kind of give you the thought process on how creating this. And also too, like, this is very easy, guys. Don't overthink this, okay? Don't think you can't do this. You can do this, okay? It's simple, okay? Understand that. It's very simple. Tell yourself that you can do it and you can do it, okay? And then we'll change the colors. So we're here, black, right? Black background. And then we'll add let's add a picture, right? So, okay, let's, for example, let's add one of these, right? Let's add, thanks for not being a prick. Okay, let's add that one. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, there we go, see? Oh, God. Let me fix that. Right there. There you go. Perfect. Okay. All right. Now, you see these little red lines? So we're going to make this design a little smaller. Okay. Boom. There's the middle of this side, right? So there's the middle right there. Boom. Okay. You can see. See, it's kind of, see where the middle is. We don't want to get too close from the left to right. And we also don't want to get close from the top to bottom. Okay. Very important that you guys understand that. And that is our front cover right there, okay? And then now we'll say the back cover. It's very simple, guys, very simple. You can come in here, you can add like some text, you can add a little like a little logo on the back or whatever you plan on doing. You can add whatever right here on the back end. But for this example, we'll just go ahead and leave it blank, okay? I just want to show you guys how easy it is to do this and customize it. You can add shapes in here. You can put some wording in those shapes so it turns it into like a little badge for the cover or whatever the heck you want to do, okay? So everything you're thinking right now, you can do it, okay? Promise you that. So then we're going to come over here to file. Okay, we're all done, guys. We're all done, by the way. We're all done. We're going to come over here to file, save as, and then here, and then we're going to save as a PDF, right? And then go over this one, save, okay, and boom, okay, saved it right there. And then what we're gonna do is come over here to KDP, and we're gonna go down here. You gotta make sure, so make sure you have all this correct stuff. So 6x9, white paper, come down, and then we're going to go ahead and come over here to upload, and then the one that we just saved, upload. Okay. And this is just an example, guys. I always use this one as a little example. And then, okay, we got everything correct. So this interior too, it's a 6x9 and it has 150 pages. Okay. Just to double check with you guys and make sure you guys are following along with me. And then we're gonna come over here to launch previewer. All right, guys. So I wanted to make sure that it went through, and I want to show you guys the proof that it went through. So the cover is good. Okay, boom, boom, the sides right here. Good, guys. Also, to a little quick pro tip, like I said, if you guys don't have the sizing right or from left to right, KDP will push it through, but it won't check it. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you check this part right here on the side, because you'll see like a little gap between the edge and the actual cover. So make sure you guys, it's very important that you guys understand that. And then you guys can see right here, we're all good. Like everything's good right here. So everything's looking nice. And then basically what I would do now is approve and go on to the next phase by pricing your book, right? So hopefully this helped. If you guys have any questions, please comment down below, but just showed you guys how to create a cover using PowerPoint. Bye.